we will see a Super Bowl ad containing cannabis this year. Also, Joe Montana is in the weeds of the tune of $75 million. What? And a NFL player is asking the NFL for permission to use cannabis in treating his injuries. All on this two episode of The News Roach. Hey, and welcome to The News Roach, where I sift through the ashtrays of forgotten weed stores this week, pick them out, hand them over to you. As always, if you like this little episode and like to see more, please subscribe, like, and or comment below. And you're always welcome to share this episode, of course. But for now, let's go straight into the stories. So not all cannabis ads will be banned at this Super Bowl 53. One company called Baristas will air an ad before, during, and after the game for their coffee and Richa Roast. It's a CBD coffee that you can find on their website, link below. So despite hemp being legalized again and cannabis being legalized in more and more states, recreational or medicinal, a lot of advertisement agencies do not want to deal with cannabis, CBD or hemp right now, except one company that actually pushed this ad through, and they are called Canna Broadcast. I will put their link in the ad. They actually went through and got this ad through. So I want you to look for that during Super Bowl. And if you can tape it and maybe share it with us, that'd be awesome. More football, more cannabis. My boy Joe Montana and his investment group is investing $75 million into a company called Calvia. Calvia, you can find them online. I will put the link below. Calvia offers different kinds of flowers. They offer oils and vapes. It's a great company. Check them out. And the reason that Joe Montana finally got into weed industry is he says he wants to help out and do something about the opiate addiction in this country. And that's a great sign. Thank you for that, Joe Montana. More cannabis, more football. And this is a story that I was not aware of, and it happened actually last year. A player called Mike James, he used to play for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Back in 2013, he got injured, and trying to get back into the game and back on the team, he was working really hard in physical therapy and all that kind of stuff to come back. Now, the pain from his injuries and from all the work he was doing, he said, cost him to take up to 200 opiates a day. You can just imagine what that does to your kidney, liver, and all that other stuff, your risk, everything. Anyway, Mike James also realized that cannabis was a much more suitable treatment for him and his injuries. So last year, 2018, he asked the NFL for what's called a therapeutic users exemption to use cannabis to treat his injuries. Unfortunately, last year the NFL said no. But one of these days I'm going to do a whole episode about the NFL and cannabis. Even though they said no now, there are some movements within the NFL to be able for players to use cannabis in the offseason and CBD to treat their injuries. But like I said, I will do a whole episode about that at a later time. Well, that's it for this episode of The News Roach. I want to thank you so much for watching. As always, please subscribe if you want to see more. Thank you again for watching. And please remember, there's THC in healthcare.